In this tutorial, you will learn how you can use routers and filters together inside IntegraMod so that you can create smarter scenarios. So first, I just want to go over the basics. I want to explain how you can create a router, how you can use them together with filters. And then I want to show you three different use cases that I'm using inside my business. So let's just dive right in. So over here, I have a scenario. So what we're going to do is we're going to build a really quick scenario so that you can see how routers and filters work. So this scenario starts with a Gmail module that is watching for new emails every 15 minutes. So every 15 minutes, it's going to check, hey, does Max have any new emails inside this inbox? If yes, then we're going to start the scenario basically and continue to the next modules. Now then what I want to do is I want to create basically a weekend replier so that if the current day of the week is a weekend day, then we're going to send people an email that says something like, hey, I will get back to you after the weekend. And if it's not weekend, maybe we send another email. So to do that, what we want to do is we want to add another module. And then over here, we want to type router, and then you see that you get flow control. Another way to do it here is go flow control and go router over here. But usually I find it fastest to just quickly type router, router, and then you see that we have a router over here. So a router, what it basically does, it allows us to create different routes inside our scenario. So by default you have two, but if you would click this another time, then you also see here that a plus appears, and then boom, you maybe get a third one if you want. So by default you have two, and if you don't set up any filters for these two routes, then the bundle basically that this module is generating will continue in both directions at the same time. So in some cases that can be really handy. We'll also show you an example of that. But in this case, we want to set up a filter. So here we create a filter because I only want people to continue in this route when it's currently weekend. So I have my weekend on a Saturday and a Sunday. So if it is currently a Saturday or a Sunday, I want it to continue down that route. And if it's any other day, I do not want it to continue down that route. So what we do, we set up a filter. You do that by clicking the line and then we give it a label. And then I say here, it's currently weekend. So this is for myself. And then we set up a condition. So the conditions, they work like this. We're going to set up the conditions, and if they match, then boom, that bundle will continue down that route. If it does not match, then bam, it will just stop. So what I do here is to say condition, okay? And then what I want to do is I want to check if it's currently weekend. And to do that, we need here the date and time functions. And what we're going to do is we're going to use format date. And then we format basically now, and this just gives us like a kind of like a machine timestamp, and we want to convert this, so format this to the current day of the week. So I know that that is DDD. So also if we would Google that, IntegraMod tokens, you can also see that down here. Then you see over here that DDDD stands for here the day name. So Sunday, Monday, Friday, Saturday, etc. So if this is equal to Saturday, then they would continue. Now, what I want to do is I also want to make sure that it's also going to continue if it is currently Sunday. So to do that, we're going to add an OR rule. So we want to do if the current day is equal to Saturday or is equal to Sunday, then we want to continue. And then maybe what we want to do is we also want to add an AND rule over here. For example, subject does not start with our E, that we know, okay, hey, it's not a response from someone. It's not so urgent to send an email back then, maybe. Here, AND. So then we have to do it again, right? Subject does not start with case insensitive R E. And then what we could do is we could send an email back to that person here. Send email to here. Sender email address. And then subject, you could maybe just say here K R E. And then subject. And then you could write your email. So you could say like, hey, hey. I will try to get back to you after the weekend, nah, etc. Like you would just like write a nice email there. And then what you could do is you could also create other routes, maybe for different kinds of emails. So you could maybe also check if the subject contains, for example here, contains insensitive invoice, and then maybe you want to forward them to your bookkeeping software, something like that. But in this case, I want to send an email back if it's not currently the weekend. So to do that, what I do here is I check here the fallback route. So this will be used in case a bundle cannot continue from the router via any other route. So if it cannot continue here, then it's going to continue here because this is our fallback route. So here I click OK. I also give this a name, fallback. And then what's also handy to know is that this arrow is different here from this one. So this is how you can recognize what a fallback looks like. And then we could maybe send a different email. So then here we say OK. Email address, subject, I will try to get back to you as soon as possible. So again, I'm not sure if you would want to use this, but it's just an example to demonstrate how a router and these filters work. Now then I want to show you three cool examples. So the first one is something that I'm using to automatically publish my YouTube videos, so videos like this, to Twitter and also automatically to my Facebook group. So this is that scenario. So over here you see that we have an RSS feed. So this is my YouTube channel. So in case you would want to use this, you need this and then your channel ID. And then what I do date from is at days now and then minus one. So from yesterday to now. And then I only want to have a maximum of one video because I would not want to post multiple things at the same time at once. Then we have a filter to check like, hey, does everything exist? Was it really created less than 24 hours ago? And then here we have a router. And then you see that I did not set up any filters because I just want to post this to Twitter and also to my Facebook group. But if I want to, for example, imagine that this Facebook group would be about IntegraMod, what I could, for example, do is I could say if the title contains maybe IntegraMod, and then only new IntegraMod YouTube tutorials, they will be posted to that Facebook group. So just another example, right? Now then the next example that I want to show you is something that I'm using to authenticate basically if an email address that enters my email service provider, which is ActiveCampaign, really exists. So if it's not like a disposable email address or a fake email address, or maybe an email address that does not exist because maybe someone made a typo. So that scenario looks like this. So over here we have a webhook module. And then by the way, if you do not know how to use these webhooks, then I also created a separate tutorial about that, which you can see up here. So here we have this webhook module. I added this to my automation inside ActiveCampaign so that whenever I have a new person on my list, boom, this webhook will be triggered. Then when I check here, okay, is this not Max? Then I use a tool called Neverbound to check, hey, is this an actual valid email address? And then because this is like really important for me to check, did this really go right? Because if this custom field, so this custom field is called, let me see, it's called email validation. If this would not have any value, then I know that people are going to get stuck inside my automations. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to use a router, and then if it is a success, so if this module gave me a result, so if the result is valid, invalid, catch all, disposable, unknown, then if it's basically any of these things, then I know like, okay, hey, this module actually worked. So then it's going to continue down here. Then we set this email validation custom field. And then here, if it's invalid or disposable, then I'm automatically going to unsubscribe these people. But then I also wanted to create an error path, basically. So it's not an error handler, don't confuse it with that, but this is basically a fallback route so that if that person would not continue down here, then I know, hey, something went wrong inside this scenario. And then I'm setting that same custom field to the field value error so that I know, hey, these people are not going to get stuck inside my automations. Now then the third example that I want to show you is going to be really cool. It's going to be a little bit more advanced because it has lots of routers, lots of routes inside a router, and also routers in routers with filters. But I just want to push your thinking a bit and give you some ideas of what you could use this for. So this is what that scenario looks like. So this is my order confirmation and refund handler. And this is basically what I'm using to process, for example, new orders or whenever there is a failed payment. So you see over here that I have a webhook module, and this is connected to Thrivecart. Capture Thrive card is my card provider that I'm using to handle all the payments for my online courses. Can really recommend it if you're still looking for a tool like that. But so whenever there is a new order, or maybe when there is a rebuild fail, then this webhook is going to get data, and then this scenario is going to start. And then you see we have a router with 5 different paths. And what I basically did here is I created different paths depending on what kind of event it was. So here, event, if it is equal to order refund, then I'm sending an email to that person like, hey, your refund was processed. Or maybe whenever there is a new order, so if the event is equal to order success, and this is not my subscription software or a coaching call that people can book, then people will continue down this path. And then you see that I create a new user inside my membership and I send a confirmation email. And then you see that we have another router here that is sending a different email if there's no account existing yet, or if they already have an account, then I send a slightly different email. And for example, when there is a failed payment, so your event is equal to order rebuild failed, then I also send a different email. So yeah, just some ideas to show you how you could use routers and filters, right? But yeah, I really hope that this helped you understand how routers and filters work inside IntegraMod. And if you still have any questions about it, just let me know in the comments below. And if you got any value from this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. That really helps me a lot.